ovation. The crowd around me are on their feet. I too am having to stand just to be able to see the players walk on to court. Lee Chong-wei, the world number one, appearing today in his ninth Malaysia Open final. He is the defending champion. He's going for his fifth consecutive title. He's going for his eighth title in total here at his home events. The man that stands in his way is 22-year-old Felice Targo. Shakes hands with the umpire, Uday Sane of India. Service judge will be Fabio Beto of Italy. The toss of the coin. Lee Chong-wei, who was doubted after a couple of losses at the end of last year to both Chen Long and Lin Dan. Well, he started 2012 answering all those critics, because a week ago in Korea he defeated Lin Dan in the final. Last night, as you can see, he defeated Chen Long 21-13 in the deciding game. He was 4-8 down in that decider. He won 10 of the next 11 points to go 49 up. And from there, really appeared to be in control. Felice Targo, well, I'm still trying to ascertain exactly what happened to Chen Jin, because Chen Jin arrived onto court. To be honest, he didn't look interested from the first rally. He didn't look interested from the warm-up, because Chen Jin was fussing about the speed of the shuttles, hardly spent any time knocking up. And then after three rallies, said that he'd had enough. His coach seemed to be saying, no, you've got to play on. But anyway, let's not worry about that. The fact is that Targo is this man's opponent today, because world number one Lee Chong-wei, despite a little wobble in the second game of the second round against Yamada when he was 4-12 down, fought back strongly, quarter-final against a former champion here in Malaysia, former World and Olympic champion Taufik Widiak, two straight games, and then Chen Long in that thriller, an hour and 16 minutes. And it's perhaps that hour and 16 minutes is what we should be taking into account when we predict today's final, because as you can see, well, Targo didn't really play yesterday, although he did go off and have a heavy training session after his opponent retired in the semi-final. Well, he had had a tough battle in the second round against the number 4 seed Peter Gaeder, came from a game down in an hour and 8 minutes. But he played less than 40 minutes for these last two rounds with Felice Targo. Well, for Malaysian fans, they will love seeing that statistic. Only twice has it been to three games. And Targo has yet, as you can see, yet to record a victory. Sane of India is going to struggle to be heard above the crowd.
And on my left, Lee Chong-wei, Malaysia. Lee Chong-wei, Malaysia.
in the final of the men's singles. It was two straight games, 21-18, 21-17. But as we were seeing just a moment ago, the hour and 16 minutes on court and the emotion also of last night's battle against Chen Long. I wonder if that's had its effect on Li Chongwei. His idol, because Kenichi Togo is tapping at. I wonder if he will revise his hero status. Well, I know he's had a victory over tapping at. He's never beaten this man, and in my opinion, so many people underestimate Li Chongwei's achievements. He's the reigning all-England champion, twice all-England champion. He's won 14 titles throughout his career so far. 24 Super Series titles. Most successful man or woman in the history of Super Series. And there are series events of his own. Judgment lies 6 straight points. Well, I was very concerned about this man yesterday in his match against Chen Long because he slipped when he was lunging forward to the net and I thought he might have hurt himself. But already, he's opening down just 4 minutes of play. He's got a run of 9 straight points, he's got a 10-2 lead, and he's moving quite beautifully. Decided to play it anyway. They're looking very much in control at the moment, the defending champion. Deep in the belief when things start to go wrong, it's really fun. Real belief, not just instilled in you by your coaches and tactical plans. It's between in the belief of knowing you have the capability. his opponent. Look at the reaction there from Kenichi Dodo. The fans don't mind that hope as long as their hero is winning. Well, when you consider he was 2-1 down, yeah, even coach Masuda is having to smile. Oh, that's nice. The problem for Targo, he knows if it's short, it's going to get severely punished. Desperately trying to get the shot into the back of the court, but maybe they're missing a decent length on this clear, and therefore vulnerable to the deceptive drop. Game points. The game 21-6, an absolute demonstration by Lee Chong-wei. 13 minutes and the opening game at a canter.
20 seconds. Second game. Long play.
Well, the question is, has Thiago got any tricks up his sleeve? Because it's not going out fast on that opening day. Service fault called. Racket not pointing in a downward direction. My goodness, mate. Thiago certainly didn't need that. Just pointing out that the court has split. We need the court's attendance. Well, the tournament referee obviously has to authorise it. Just inspecting the fact that we need running repairs here. Well, Thiago has the opportunity to talk to Peter Masuda, his coach. And, well, he's trying to relax, Thiago. Son of a very famous badminton player, Toshiko Yonifura. In the women's doubles, with Toshiko Fukuda. Won a bronze medal at the World Championships in Jakarta. As a patron of Badminton Association Malaysia, and then this is why. I have to say, the tournament organizer has been desperately slow. To find the right personnel and repair the court. And Thiago has openly said he wants to achieve what his mother achieved in the sport, and that's it, his sights very, very high indeed. Well, no, that's not going to do the job, I'm afraid. That piece of tape, quite frankly, will be dangerous. I can't believe that, surely. Surely they need to re-zip that. I can't put a little flimsy bit of tape on the centre line. Oh, the crowd are already rejoicing. Their man, their hero. Already a game up. Well, I find that absolutely extraordinary. If he wants the zipper has come undone. It's literally like a giant zip that holds the court together. Once it's come apart in one bit, then if the player steps on it a little further down, it will rip even further apart. Well, I'm absolutely astonished that the players have agreed to play on. Thank you. takes his time, and then suddenly the power play. All the pace of movement, especially coming forward to the net, suddenly moves a lot quicker and creates opportunities. There's the pace of movement getting back in here, but that's how I'm fumbling now the trouble. Precision on the net play. Shuttle hits the top of the tape, game's over. So difficult for Targo. Complaining about flash photography behind the court. Well, the net exchange there is superb. Trips up his sleeve, but at the moment he has absolutely no answers whatsoever. Too clever on that occasion. And while certainly at the moment this men's singles final is only one-sided, you shouldn't forget that at the start of the tournament, the top three Chinese players were all seen as potential threats to Lee Chong Wei. Two of them fell by the wayside, beaten. And then the third too late. Beaten in that swill-up yesterday by Lee Chong Wei himself. Well, he used to be on a winner's title. I think that's not playing against Chinese opposition in today's final. Does not subtract from the achievement one little bit. No. As much as anything, I should think. Well, the crowds rejoice at the fact that Chen Long has just been shown on the giant screen. And rejoice in the fact that he's in the crowd today and their hero is on court. Urgency in the style of play from Targo. Well, he was trying to in that way, he was trying to up with his intensity. Creeping ever closer to his goal of his eighth title here. Ricardo was really threatening with his positioning on court. Oh, he's trying to wind into error. Disappointed with that. Because Meno Lee Chong Wei is so close to this amazing feat of an eighth title here. But all credit to Targo, because he's continuing to battle. Some liquid. Just towel down. Recompose the thoughts. Big, deep breath. Yeah. It's there for the taking.
world number one, Lee Chong-wei, winner of the Maybank Malaysia Open for 2012. What a start to 2012.
And one more, Lee Chong-wei.
Olympic year, of course. And for Lee Chong-wei to have come back at the start of this year, having been, in my opinion, wrongly criticised at the end of last year because of a couple of losses to Lin Dan and Chen Wei, to come back and win the first two Super Series events of the year is extraordinary. And the manner in which she's won these two events is even more extraordinary. But there he is, an amazing man, an amazing athlete, and a gracious champion too. Went to the first of the Super Series events this year in Seoul and Korea last week. He said he wasn't expecting to win, just wanted to concentrate on getting through to the final. He not only got through to the final, it was a dream final as far as us fans are concerned, because it was against the reigning world and Olympic champion. He defeated Lin Dan in the final a week ago. All the Chinese stars have fallen by the wayside this week in Kuala Lumpur. So for a second consecutive Super Series event in 2 weeks on tour, Lee Chong-wei has proved beyond any doubt in my mind why exactly he is the world number one. To the fans, well, some of our dignitaries, some of which I'm sure will be coming down onto the arena floor to take part in the men's singles presentation. Patron of Badminton Association Malaysia, Prime Minister's wife,
I think will be coming down to the arena floor. Well, Malaysian fans delighted to see themselves on the giant screen. Well, Malaysian fans in general, so delighted to see Lee Chong Wei pick up the Malaysian Open title once again. We're just getting advice on protocol. Well, Kenichi Targo now has been in three Super Series tournament finals. He's lost two of them. All three of them to this man. Yet to pick up a Super Series title for Lee Chong Wei. Of course, it is his 25th Super Series title, which of course includes three Super Series finals titles. Kenichi Targo wasn't a match for Lee Chong Wei today, beaten in all departments, but it doesn't mean he didn't fight. He gave it everything he could. He simply wasn't good enough. Top of the podium here at the Malaysia Open. His fifth consecutive title here. His 25th Super Series title. No other singles player comes close to that sort of record.
Champion will also receive a challenge trophy, specially sponsored by Maybank for men's singles event.
Well, a trophy for the men's singles champion. The dignitaries will pose with the two finalists. But the home fans, delighted to say, they've all remained not only for this prize presentation, but also, of course, because we've got one more final to come. Moving this doubles final, coming up in just a moment. But delight for the home fans, the only Malaysian participating in today's finals. Disappointment, of course, earlier in the week when the top Malaysian men's doubles pair of Kufian Kiat and Tan Boon Kiong. Disappointment for them, disappointment for the fans in an early exit. But of course, there was something to celebrate in the mixed doubles for Malaysia. and two women's doubles pairs in the quarter-final stage. But today, as far as the home fans are concerned, they want to enjoy the moment. The moment that their hero, Lee Chong Wei, took his eighth Malaysian Open title.